Welcome back to my channel once more. I'm Dipanjana and you are watching Tasty Recipes with Dipanjana.
Today I'm going to show you how to make chicken tikka biryani, a perfect combination of two delicious Mughlai dishes. So let's see how to make this delicious recipe. Firstly, I have taken 500 grams of boneless chicken. So guys, firstly I'm taking a tablespoon of curd. You can also take mayo or fresh cream. Now 2 teaspoons of lime juice. If you don't have lime juice, you can also add a teaspoon of white vinegar. Now 2 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder. This will impart a nice red color. Then a 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Then 1 tablespoon of chicken tandoori masala. Now into it I am adding a teaspoon of red food color. Now I am adding some oil. Now guys, I have added 2 tablespoons of mustard oil because its pungent flavor will give a very nice taste to the chicken tikka. So try to add mustard oil. Now guys, we are going to mix it up very well and after that keep it into the fridge for 30 minutes. Next guys, I have taken a non-stick pan. Keep the flame on medium and heat it up. After the pan is hot enough, add the chicken pieces and we are going to cook the chicken pieces on medium flame for 15 to 20 minutes. Don't add any sort of oil or butter. So guys, after 20 minutes, you can see our first batch of chicken tikka is ready. You can also use skewers instead of this method. And after the first batch, cook the other chicken pieces as well. So now guys, we are going to make the biryani. For that, I have taken the same pan. Now into it, I am adding 2 teaspoons of clarified butter or ghee. You can also use half and half if you don't have ghee. After the ghee has melted, into it I am adding 1 teaspoon of ginger, garlic and onion paste. You can also add the paste separately. Then 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1/2 teaspoon of chicken tandoori masala. Then 1 teaspoon of biryani masala. We are going to saute the masalas for 2 minutes on medium flame. And after all the spices are completely very well sauteed, we are going to add 1/4 cup of tomato puree. If you don't have tomato puree, you can also add chopped tomatoes. Cook it on medium flame for 5 minutes. After the tomatoes are done, add the remaining marination spice. So guys, after that you can see our masala mix is almost done and the oil is also getting separated. That means our tomatoes are done and the spices are very well mixed. Now into it I'm adding 1/4 teaspoon of salt. We are going to add salt conveniently because we have already added salt into the chicken. So add salt conveniently. Now some garam masala. That's just the finishing touch to the spice mix, like a teaspoon of it or 1/2 teaspoon of it. So our spice mix for the chicken tikka is done. Now we are going to add the chicken tikkas that we have kept aside. We are going to mix it along with the curry very well. You can also serve it like this guys, but this is not the end of the recipe. So after mixing the curry peas with the curry mix with the chicken tikkas very well, we are just going to mix it for 2 minutes. After that we are going to add the rice. So guys, I have taken around 1 cup of rice and I am going to add it into batches. Because my pan is small and it will get overcrowded if I add it all together. You can see that I have taken the same marination bowl for the rice as well. So that the excess marination also comes up along with the rice and nothing gets wasted. So this is the first batch and we are going to mix it along with the chicken tikka. But guys, before mixing, we are going to add some necessary things for the biryani. So I am taking around 1/2 teaspoon of kewra water or kewra essence, then just 1/8 teaspoon of red food color, 1/4 teaspoon of biryani masala and then around 2 drops of mitha aator. This is very essential. This will give a very nice flavor to the biryani and this will look like exactly the market bought. So after adding all these necessary things, we are going to mix it very well on low flame. Just mix it up and it's looking already delicious, wonderful. Now it's time for the second batch as well guys and nothing is wasted. All have come up along with the rice. Now the remaining kewra water and another 2 drops of mitha aator. If you are not getting mitha aator in your area, then that's fine. It will not make any sort of difference. That's not an issue actually. If you have the kewra water, then that will also do the work. But mitha aator gives a further flavor to the biryani and that is also used in the market. Now some biryani masala and 2 drops of red food color. So guys, now we are going to mix it up very well. And this biryani is a combination of chicken tikka and biryani. On one side, you're getting the taste of the chicken tikka. On the other side, the flavors of the biryani. So it's all mixed up and it's completely ready to serve on the table. Guys, I hope you liked this recipe. If you did, make sure to like, share and comment. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel. And if you want to get updated with more tasty recipes, hit the bell button next to it to never miss an update from my channel.